Welcome to Ettingshall Local Neighbourhood Partnerships 2010 DVD, which gives you a brief glance of some of the achievements this year. Rather than use a formal written annual report, we like to use a more dynamic presentation style. So here goes, hold on to your seats and let's have a quick look back at 2010. It was me and you, 'cause we are gonna be.
I'm Liam Evans and I'm from All Saints.
I'm William Clayton and I'm from All Saints.
I'm Thomas Clayton and I'm from All Saints.
I'm Nathan Evans and I'm from All Saints.
We all live by each other and we all went on the five course together.
Can you tell me about anything else you know about the local neighbourhood partnership?
Very not, because there's leaflets coming from our door and it gives us lots of information on what's happening and where and where it's happening, like a local area in Whitehorse, which is Dixon Street.
Can you remember any events or anything you've been to that's been organised by the local neighbourhood partnership, Nathan?
Oh yeah, we went to one at Dixon Street field. It was like a family fun day. And there was All Saints Football Club giving a five-a-side football, and also all the balls were there doing some rugby skills.
Did you have a good time that day?
Yeah, we had a really good time.
Well, we did activities and we had our lunches there for all 3 days. And we had to practice pretending to be firefighters, getting some people out of the building that was on fire, and we had to put out the fire on a car and get the people, the five people out of the building.
We all had a certificate at the end, and we all did a presentation, and we all gave a round of applause. And the parents all arrived and they were really proud of us.
Well, can you tell me if any of you have got new career choices now?
We want to be firemen! Don't wear your heart on your
sleeve. Too many lives to... Right, my name is Mark Smith, I'm 17 and from Blackmore. I've done the mentoring course because I want to learn new skills about the boys and to get me off the street and help young people help young people fix up the boys and learn new skills in motocross. I enjoyed learning new skills in motocross and doing the jumps and that. And I'd say the worst part is doing the mechanics, but everybody finds that boring. Do you know what
Okay, whereabouts are we at the moment?
We are stood on one of the public footpaths off Taylor Road, and we are here to discuss future proposals for the improvement of the footpaths leading to a new adventure playground.
What other service providers have you worked with to look at this site?
I've contacted the Disability Access Officer within the Wolverhampton City Council, and we're liaising with the Ettingshall Local Neighbourhood Partnership.
Have any other people in the area approached you regarding the footpath and its usage?
Not members of the public. The inquiry has come through the LNP.
Right, I'm Jason Evans, I'm chairman of All Saints Football Club, local run community club for kids in the area. I've been chairman for 5 years. We're a local base club that's based in training in Southside and at Dixon Street Field.
How have you managed to support this team?
Well, we've got local funding. We had struggled this season, but we've got local funding off LNPD, and this helps put these teams where are unfunded and don't collect as much subs because the brothers play in the teams. And The equipment, new balls, new bibs, new goalie stuff helped funding us this season. This is one of the three new teams that we've had out of the funding this season. So we've got a lot of young lads, what we're going through now, where they're just leaving school to go on their FI badges, and that gives them a little bit of a career. As you said, some of the coaches gives them some management skills, some courses, as you said, it's an FI qualified course. Yeah, it's helped us out a big way. As he says, this team wouldn't have played if we didn't get the funding, because they would lose probably £30, £25 a week. At the club, as he says, we've got about 12 teams now with the adults teams and things. There's about 175 kids, and we've got probably about 25 in the adults team, and then we've got probably 30 coaches or members of staff that help out, like on the committee and stuff. As he says, we'd like to work more with LNP, because for us to grow, with their like their percentage, their funding, what they give us this year, helped us grow by another 30%. And we're funding off them like over the next couple of years. We could grow and grow, but without them, we would struggle. And the club growth would only probably be 5%, as with help from them and working from Dixon Street Field and working in Ettingshall and getting new players in, the growth for the club will be growing by 30%. And it's a big difference to the club.
Heroes, just for one day.
Hello there, my name's John Pritchett from British Waterways. I'm the project manager, helping to deliver this scheme as part of the ABCD works, as well as a further access scheme, which I'll talk about in a sec. The project is worth £425,000. The bid was put together by BW with the help of Ettingshall LNP. Some letters of support came from Ettingshall LNP, which BW used as part of the bid submission to ABCD. The idea of the project, the title, was Safer and Better Access. The premise behind it was to improve the perception of safety on the canal, increase accessibility for all the local community, and it was also in direct response to some of the initial feedback we received that people would like to see certain openings recreated where they used to be at this bridge, Cable Street, and at one further on at Lower Walsall Street Bridge. As part of the works to increase the perception of safety to the towpaths, the parapets to Cable Street Bridge were lowered. You can see the height that the parapets used to be, just on the remnant on the wall. They were reduced so that the passive surveillance from street level is increased onto the towpath. Same goes for the other side as well. This is the second access we were told to look at by Ettingshall LNP as one of the recommended access points. one of the accesses that is most beneficial to people in this area. This is why we sort of approached this. The steps have replaced a former ramp that used to be in situ here. Just one small feature to note on the steps is we've also included a cycle wheeling channel to the right, made out of brickwork as well. That was a request from Sustrans to try and fit one of those in. Just for one day.